Hello student, welcome to History and Political Science, Standard 9. We are going to start Chapter 1st of History, Sources of History, Part 3. In this part, we are going to study the oral sources. These sources include folk tales, folk songs, which is popular songs which is sung by the common local people, proverbs, ballads, and ovis, abhangas, bharudas. These are written in Marathi. Activists were inspired by the povadas of Lokshair Anna Bhau Sathe and Shahir Amar Sheikh during the Sanyukta Maharashtra movement. At this time, the Bharudas were written, the Povadas were written, were inspiring one. As an example of how some events get reflected in literature and how a poet previews that event, study the poem Ahvaan, written by Kusumagraj, that is Viva Sirvarkar, on Sino-Indian War in 1962. Find pieces of literature based on contemporary events. So, such things are reflected through this literature and people are challenged, people are asked to take active part in such movements. So in this way, the oral sources helps people to take part in it. Let us see the audio visual sources. They are television, film, internet. Audio, which we can hear, and visual means we can see. So both together they are audiovisual media. Many domestic and foreign television channels also come under this head. For example, History Channel, Discovery Channel, etc. So such audiovisual media also helps us to write the history in a very possible way. It gives us lots and lots of information. Film and Television Institute of India, which is called FTII. The Government of India started the Film and Television Institution of India at Pune in 1960. With the purpose of providing public education. An institution called Indian News Review has produced various news reels on important events in politics, social issues, arts, sports, and culture. This department has also produced various documentaries on prominent social leaders, on people who have made major contribution for the country, and about important locations in India. For example, Mahatma Gandhi has done a lot of contribution, and therefore we know that film Gandhi has been there. Or different films on different leaders. For example, 1857, Mangal Pandey film is there. So such people who have made a lot of contribution for the country, on them the films are depicted. This news release and documentaries are useful for studying the history of modern India. Which films about patriotism do you know of? So write in your own word a review on one such film. You can such films are Gadar or Border or any other film you must take and write a review of. Till now, we have seen some important sources for writing the history of modern India. The times in the 21st century are changing so rapidly that even these sources will prove to be inadequate. So the sources which we are using now, they will be inadequate. They will be considered as the past sources, and they will give us, they will tell us about the history. However, new sources are coming forth. For example, during the transformation from landline telephone to cell phones, a gadget called pager came up for contacting people, but it died out as quickly as it had come up. The huge amount of information available on the internet is used for studying history. On one click of search engine, you can get everything under the sky. But, my dear student, the truth and authenticity of this information needs to be verified, needs to be checked, needs to be found out whether it is authentic. Now, it has become comparatively easy to study history with all these sources, as these sources are from the contemporary period. From the contemporary period, they are easily available, since a subject like history touch all the aspects of our life. Efforts for preservation of such sources are made at all level. We should also contribute to this effort. In this way, my dear students, we have studied the sources of modern history. Among that, written sources, print media, newspaper, Press Trust of India, that is PTI, postal stamp, all these we have studied. Then we have also studied the material sources and oral sources. Read the lesson and complete the exercises. Good day.